The Sky is Crying, released almost a year after Stevie's death, features various tracks recorded with Double Trouble from 1984 through 1989. The album would showcase the many different musical styles and influences of Stevie, from slow blues like the title track, to extended jams like on Hendrix's Little Wing, to up-tempo blues like the song we'll be looking at, Empty Arms. So in order to play along with Empty Arms, or any of Stevie's stuff for that matter, you're going to want to tune down one half step from standard, so here are your pitches to match. Okay, Empty Arms is an up-tempo shuffle, and we're in the key of C throughout. Now this opening four bars has us right in eighth position C minor pentatonic. One, two, three. So, C minor pentatonic is a good starting point, but keep in mind that SRV uses the minor and major third notes, or E flat and E natural, and he uses the major sixth, or A note, quite a bit in the song. Knowing the C minor pentatonic box in eighth position will help here. A lot of Stevie's fills and solos use it. Okay. After that initial four bars, the band enters and we introduce the song's main guitar theme. Here's what it should sound like slowed down a bit. Two, three, four. When we reach the verse, Stevie begins responding to his vocal lines with chord stabs and a small part of the main guitar theme. There's a few chord voicings you want to look at here. First, we'll call this a C9. Next, we use this F9 shape. And last, the small voicing of a G9. The guitar solo once again uses the C minor pentatonic. Much of it once again in eighth position. At the tail end of the solo, Stevie uses a few new chord voicings up the neck. First, we'll call this a C7 sharp 9. And here's a small F13 voicing.